The next failure theory that we discuss is the distortion energy, or DE theory. This theory is also called octahedral shear stress, or von Mises theory, named after Richard von Mises, who formulated the theory in 1913. This theory was based on the observations that yielding was not a simple tensile or compressive phenomenon at all, but rather, it was related to the angular distortion of the stressed element. This can be schematically explained in this figure. Consider a three-dimensional stress state designated by the three principal normal stresses. This stress state can be decomposed into the following two states. First, the hydrostatic stress, which is the normal stresses, having the same magnitude acting on all surfaces. The result of hydrostatic stress is pure volume change and no angular distortion. The second stress element is subjected to the stress values of average stress subtracted from principal stresses. This stress element undergoes pure angular distortion and no volume change and is responsible for yielding. This theory predicts that yielding occurs when the distortion energy reaches or exceeds the distortion energy for yield in tension testing of the same material. Distortion energy can be calculated by the following equation in terms of principal stresses, sigma 1, sigma 2, and sigma 3. In this equation, nu is Poisson's ratio, and E is Young's modulus, or modulus of elasticity. Now let's calculate the distortion energy at yielding during a tensile test. For the tensile test at yield, we have sigma 1 equals Sy, and sigma 2 and sigma 3 are 0. Substituting these values in the distortion energy equation gives the following. Equating the last two equations and canceling out the constants, and taking the square root of each side gives the following equation, which is the mathematical representation of yield failure in ductile materials according to this theory. It's common to consider the left-hand side of this equation as an equivalent stress representative of the entire general state of stress. It is called von Mises stress and is shown by sigma prime. So the yielding failure can be formulated as sigma prime equals Sy. Therefore, the safety factor based on the distortion energy theory is defined as Sy over sigma prime. In addition to the previous formula, the von Mises stress can also be expressed in terms of the general stress components, sigma x, sigma y, sigma z, tau xy, tau xz and tau yz. And for two-dimensional plane stress, the von Mises stress in terms of principal stresses and general stress components is simplified to the following equations. Let's visualize the safe and failure zones for the distortion energy theory. We start by drawing sigma A and sigma B on a set of axes and mark the material's yield strength on the axis. The failure equation in the distortion energy theory is sigma prime equals Sy, which is the equation of a rotated ellipse in the xy coordinate system. It can be easily plotted. Inside of the ellipse represents the safe, non-yielding region, while outside of it indicates yielding failure for ductile materials.